Find the measure of angle D. Here's angle D right here. The measure of angle D is represented by 6y plus 3 degrees. Let's look what other information we have. The other information related to angles is down here, this angle B, which is opposite to angle D. Measure is represented by 8y minus 19 degrees. Now, since we know we have a parallelogram, the opposite angles are congruent. So we can say measure of angle D equals the measure of angle B. So then we can just say simply 6y plus 3 equals 8y minus 19. Now we can solve for y and then figure out the measure of angle D. First step is I'm going to subtract 6y from both sides. So that simply leaves 3 equals and then 2y minus 19. Add 19 to both sides. 22 equals 2y. Then I'm going to divide by 2. So 11 equals y. Now the measure of angle D is represented by 6y plus 3 degrees. And I know y is 11, so I can substitute. It's going to be 6 times 11 plus 3. And I'm going to leave off the degrees for convenience, but I'll keep it in mind, so I'll put a degree symbol at the end. I just don't want to get confused with double parentheses and all that right now. So that equals 6 times 11 is 66 plus 3. So finally, the measure of angle D equals 66 plus 3, which is 69, and degrees is our unit of measure. Okay, let's review the process. We have a parallelogram, so we use the relationship that opposite angles are congruent. Then we wrote an equation, solve for y, and then use the y value to figure out the value of 6y plus 3, which turned out to be 69 degrees.